We don't even know the capabilities of this prototype yet. It was made to expand the scope of human experience. You know, it can lift thousands of pounds and it can step over like 2, 3, 4 foot objects. The sky's the limit. My name is Jonathan Tippett. I'm a mechanical engineer, an inventor, entrepreneur, some would say a mad scientist. I've always kind of been interested in building. When I was a kid, it was plasticine dinosaurs and Lego spaceships, radio-controlled cars, and just basically continued that trajectory with bigger and better and more powerful tools. I graduated from UBC in 1999, mechanical engineering. I went to Burning Man around 2003, and I kind of got inspired by the amazing creations you see there. And my friends and I did our own sort of homegrown junkyard wars. And one year, we built a fully functional, articulated, eight-legged, rideable walking machine. And it walked like 20 steps until it collapsed in a heap of pieces. And a bunch of friends then went on to build Mondo Spider, which is a 2,000-pound electric-powered, rideable, mechanical spider.
Celebrating science and engineering!
But the coolest thing I ever made is my giant racing mech. Prosthesis is an 8,500-pound, 200-horsepower, fully pilot-controlled, four-legged exoskeleton. So here's the machine. This is the beast. This is one of the giant 1,000-pound, 10-foot-tall legs. There's four of them. They have custom-made racing suspension on them. And up front here, you have the bumper bars. These are sort of the hardest-working part of the machine. You can see they kind of take the brunt when you fall, which happens a lot. They have massive impact-absorbing shocks on them, so you can fall from a full 15 feet up faceplant and you barely even feel it. You'll see right square in the middle, that's the cockpit of the machine. That's where you strap in to take control of it. It amplifies your strength about 100 times, and that's it. It doesn't figure anything out for you, it doesn't catch your balance for you, it just makes you powerful enough to operate an 8,500-pound body. The essence of the machine is to celebrate the age-old pursuit of physical mastery and human skill. Its sole job is to pay attention to what the pilot is telling it. It doesn't make any decisions for you. It doesn't try and catch you if you're falling. You can see the feet have been beat and battered. These things have been one of the most challenging parts of the project because they're literally where the rubber hits the road. They've stood up amazingly well for a first revision. My wife thinks I'm nuts, which is really the only way that she would put up with me, because I think she's nuts too, and that's why we love each other. And all my friends are crazy like me, like they build giant robotic sculptures, so it was easy to find acceptance amongst my peers. It's the strangers you meet every now and then who are like, you're building what? To do what? Out of this first prototype, we hope to start getting people excited about what the experience is like, and eventually this will lead to a sporting competition with an international mech racing league. So you can picture 5 or 10 years from now, lighter, faster, more agile versions of these things ripping around courses, obstacle courses, jumps, pushing boulders out of the way. I think it's going to be a pretty wild spectacle to behold. The coolest thing I ever made is my giant racing mech. Can I strap in now?